Today is a sunny March 29th, 2023. I'm in Speonk, one of the more romantic town names on Long Island. Just got off train 38 from Babylon. Train's heading into the yard. All right, coming out of the yard at 2:52 is the equipment for train 94, one of those Eastern Suffolk commuter services. He heads to Montauk, originating here in Speonk. Restaurant in the last 50 years at least. There he goes, 3:06 p.m. This Eastern Suffolk service started several years ago when they remoted the railroad track east of Speonk out to Montauk, serving commuters, East End towns. The companies provide shuttle buses to the station to get the workers to the office. Okay, time is 4:04 p.m. Approaching now is train 17, en route from Montauk to Jamaica. I'll be boarding here to go to Jamaica, which happens to be the next stop.
Schedule change. This nonstop run was created from Speonk on this train 17, which used to be 2709. I was a Montauk to Jamaica local, made local stops to Babel and then Jamaica. Now we have two trains doing the work of that one. Get to listen to that horn. Kind of has an interesting way of blowing it. A little horn artistry there. Right behind this train is 45, which originates in Speonk and goes to Jamaica. Makes local stops to Babel and then Jamaica. So 17 and 45 today are doing the work that 2709 used to do before the schedule change. Nonstop run from Speonk to Jamaica on this weekday afternoon train. I mean, I know during the summer months, 2709 used to get quite crowded. Workers in the Hamptons used this train heavily, but we're not quite there yet. This train is fairly empty. Shortly, a bunch of crossings. cinema richest station. Be passing over the Forge River. And there it is. Weekend trains that make runs like this, nonstop, West Hampton, Jamaica, Speonk-Jamaica. Quite an anomaly. This new schedule change has created a lot of new operating patterns. New schedules, new train numbers. Through the interlocking of JJD. Refuge. Wide expanse of wilderness. Thank you. large wilderness area. Walking through here in the summertime, you're asking for trouble with ticks. Looks like there's a decent hiking path over there. Stump Road. This is the site of the old Brookhaven station. Painter's Restaurant. It's a pretty good spot from what I've been told. Good food, spirits. Never been there. In for the crossings that I don't know or don't recall. Approaching Bayport, Hagerman area, lots of railroad crossings, especially going into Patchogue. Station. On these cab cars, but I'm certainly getting an overdose here. Hopefully I won't be driven insane by the time I get to Jamaica. This train takes the Montauk branch west of Babylon, so there are no road crossings. This is the community of Hagerman. The Patchogue yard limit. This train at 45 have to take the Montauk branch because you have around the same time 18 for Montauk and 80 for Patchogue coming down the central branch. quite a bit as we go through Patchogue. Train 76 from Jamaica comes in a Patchogue around now. That's why you might be slowing. We're approaching the eastward limits of PD Interlaken. Siding. I've never ridden on this track before. This is a first for me. Ocean Avenue crossing. Yeah, 76 isn't here yet. He's approaching the west limits of PD. Looks like he's got a stop signal. Stop. Now here comes 76 arriving from Jamaica. Switch of PD, we should be on our way. Hopefully we won't stop anymore until we get to Jamaica. This 76 was the old 2772. Six is 10 minutes late. If he was on time, he would have cleared the switch. Well, this is West Avenue, so I got to experience some rare mileage, although it wasn't quite a mile. To ride on a track I've never ridden on before, the siding at PD. Doing Jamaica at 5:25. This is the site of the old Blue Point station. It was Blue Point Avenue down there. And a bunch of crossings up ahead. Bayport.
So
Bayport station. That was Snedeker. Chicken, maybe? Stop run thus far. Begin double track. Avenue. Bohemia Road, Oakdale Station. Cutting arboretum here. Nice place to walk. Shooting for some fans out there. Just under the Heckscher Parkway. This is a busy piece of railroad this time of day for westbounds. We got this train. You have 45 and 76 actually goes back to Babylon as an equipment move. So you got three westbounds, bang, bang, bang. Was 78 that just passed. Babylon Patchogue Scoot. That's Carlton Avenue, East Islip. Coming up to Irish Lane Crossing. Places to get shots of trains. Certainly like the name of the street. This summer I hope to see a lot of Irish lanes in Ireland. Islip Avenue. Islip Station. Nassau. Thank you. Jackson Avenue. Through Bayshore, the whole bunch of crossings. Station. Biking destinations. The road out there is Union Boulevard. Let's see how this train negotiates Babylon. Stand of Babylon interlock. Higbee Lane, West Islip, our last railroad crossing. And I think I'm still sane. as he blows his horn for the stations on the Montauk branch, flying through. Under the right conditions, you can blow right on by Babylon. Approximate location of the old Babylon Tower. Here's Deer Park Avenue. It used to have manually operated gates when it was at ground level. Going down track 2 in Babylon. Supposed to go via the central branch. Okay. There's a local ahead of us. Let's see what the dispatcher does as we look at Argyle Lake. Harbor Avenue. It used to be a crossing down there when this was at ground level. Approaching Lindenhurst, home sweet home. Wellwood Avenue. South Broadway. This is 5th Street. Used to be a crossing here. This is 8th Street. Also a crossing at one time. Avenue, also a crossing. Lindenhurst, Copeng, and Amityville were elevated in 73. This is Copeng. Diesel trains in electrified territory is 80. Looks like he's doing every bit of it. See the new yard track that they built here at east of Massapequa Station. Right in the middle of the two tracks here. There it is. Interlocking is Massapequa. Massapequa Station. Seaford Station. Traffic. Belmore. This is a 14 car platform. I didn't know any better. I'd say the Flying Yankee was running this train. Switches. There's a covered hopper down there that's not going anywhere. There's no way for it to get out. It's been there for years. This is port. Freeport. By Lombardo Town.
I'm not going to talk about it.
west of here, we're going to drop down to ground level. Going through a little chunk of Oceanside, the northern boundary. This line is primarily elevated. Yeah, right here is Oceanside. We're even with the ground. Not many places this is true on this Babylon electrification. Now we're going back up. Coming to Rockville Center. Soon we'll be thumping over Rocky Interlocking. Yo, Adrian. Right there. Building is train land, model railroad shop. And joining up with us here is the Long Beach branch. Very important interlocking of Valley. West Hempstead branch joins on the right. You won't see it. West Hempstead branch has changed since the schedule change in February. No more scoots. Run to Atlantic Terminal now, and they run every hour on the West Hempstead branch. With that kind of frequency, it's definitely worth rail fanning. This is Valley Interlocking. There's the Far Rockaway branch joining on the left. There's Valley Tower there. Valley Stream Station. So West End of Valley interlocking. There's two tracks out there. That's the Atlantic branch. It begins at Valley. Valley is the beginning of four branches. The Atlantic branch to the west, the Far Rockaway, Long Beach, and West Hempstead to the east. The only constant is the Montauk branch, which goes right on through. There's Green Acre Shopping Mall. We're approaching the Queens Line. Sunrise Highway leaves us. That's the Belt Parkway out there. And we'll kiss the Atlantic branch goodbye until just before we come into Jamaica. Over there is the Laurelton Station. Space between the tracks here, that's where the old Springfield Garden Station used to be. Long gone. Say, this has been an eventful and exciting ride. Had a little delay at Patchogue waiting for 76. Some kind of unexplained phenomenon at Bayport when we stopped at, but I don't know what happened there. But since then, this guy's been, other than slowing through Babylon, he's been flying. Gotta try riding this train again. Hopefully 76 will be on time and there won't be any holdups. on the viaduct. To jump over the main line. To the hillside maintenance complex, those two tracks there on the far end. You got main line tracks 4 and 2. Doing at 5:25, he might just make it on schedule. He was 5 minutes late out of Speonk, but there's a little padding in the schedule between Speonk and Patchogue, I know. He was delayed in Patchogue, he was a little delayed in Bayport, slowed down in Babylon. If he can make it in on time, it'd be quite a run, quite a accomplishment by this engineer. Everybody talks about what is defined as on time. They say like within 6 minutes of the arrival time is on time. To me, on time is on time. Getting there on the advertised time. Distant suburb of Speonk to the urbanized area of Jamaica. Train leaving. There's the Atlantic branch coming back in. Ends right here at Hall. Well, I shouldn't say that. Continues on to Brooklyn, Atlantic Terminal. But it's interrupted a little bit going through Jamaica. MP-15AC. There's the old Hall Tower there. Goes a West Hempstead train. Busy Jamaica hub. We're arriving on track number 3. There's 405. Thank you. I have got 5:25. We are exactly on time. Excellent ride.
It's our cab car. As I was getting off the train, I heard the engineer say to the conductor that he almost hit somebody at Bayport. Kind of figured that's what happened, but he still got in on time. Got M3s all over the place. Got one going to Brooklyn. We got this one sitting west of the station. Goes to the yard. AC-401 did the honors on that long express run. Great ride. Well, for the first time, I'm standing on the platform shared for tracks 11 and 12, which is used primarily for Atlantic Terminal shuttles. We got an M3 departing for Atlantic Terminal. Man, it's M3 City here. He's going in on track 7. A Babylon bound train here. That other M3 set I saw going east was for 1964 going to Ronkonkoma. Got a brand new vantage point for rail fanning at Jamaica here. That M3 set that departed for Atlantic Terminal was train 2941. Alright, 5:40, here comes train 2962 from Atlantic Terminal to Jamaica with yet another set of M3s. On this platform. 28 from Atlantic Terminal to here with M7s. 544. This platform and this view, I feel like that this is a station I've never been to before. And we'll watch 2943 depart for Atlantic Terminal with M3s. See him knock down the J98L signal. Something new here. Grand Central bound train on track 2. This is 2765 from Far Rockaway that will be coming in shortly. It's weird coming here and listening for announcements and hearing Grand Central, hearing track 11, track 12. I mean, what station is this? All right, here he comes. Let's see that announcement for Grand Central. Leaving from track 4, there goes the Ronkonkoma Rocket, train 2068. He'll soon be rocketing down the main line, track number 1. It's a Wantagh train on track 7 with M3s. Okay, I rode train 270 out of Jamaica to Lindenhurst. Just got off here at Lindenhurst. Train made St. Albans, express to Wanton, all stops. Now I noticed an interesting operating pattern involving Wanton. 1266 from New York to Wanton with M3s. We saw that arrive Jamaica and he left ahead of us. We caught up to him at port. We switched over to track one to run around him, and we both got into Wanton at the same time. We're scheduled to arrive like 3 minutes later after he does. So then we pulled out ahead of 1266. 1266 made his last stop at Wanton, so he was empty after that. We pulled out ahead of him, switched back over to track two at Wanton, and now 1266's equipment with the M3s is coming here at Lindenhurst, chasing 270. Here he comes. It's been a M3 fest the latter part of this date. Concludes an interesting, I don't know what you want to call it, a triangle trip. I call it more like a slingshot trip, going from here to Speonk and then flipping all the way to Jamaica and back to Lindenhurst again. It was exciting.